Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today the Android 11 October security update is here, and this is the first security update since the launch of Android 11. And so this is available for all supported Pixel devices, starting with the Pixel 2 and on up to the Pixel 4a, as well as probably Pixel 5, but they don't mention that anywhere. Maybe we'll see it launch with this particular update. And then many of you who are on Samsung devices will probably get the update soon, if not already. And then the other devices, it's up to your manufacturer. So let me know in the comments below if you've already received this. Now, this particular update came in at 10.53 megabytes on my Pixel 4 XL. And again, it can vary depending on which device you're using. Let's take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. And this build is RP1A.201005.004. You can't see the four here, it's cut off, but that's the build number. And this update brings quite a few improvements to sensors and the system UI, and then as well as security updates. So the first thing is they improved sensors, and I'll go over what devices are specifically affected by what update. Now for the Pixel 3 through 4a, they've improved auto rotation on certain devices. So if you were having an issue with auto rotation when you were going to different applications, that should now be resolved. They've also improved the sensor for auto brightness in certain lighting conditions, but that's specific to the Pixel 4a, not the 4 XL or any of the other Pixels. Now, as far as the system is concerned, they fixed some devices that were stuck during boot. This covers all of the supported Pixel devices. And then also with the call UI, maybe you're using Do Not Disturb or one of those sort of options, so you're not getting a lot of calls. However, there was an issue where you could inadvertently disable call notifications, and so they've fixed that on all of the Pixel devices that are supported. Now, going back to that auto rotate issue that I mentioned earlier, they've also improved an issue where the button for auto rotate may disappear, and they've fixed that on all supported Pixel devices. And then again with the system UI, they've fixed undetected overview swipe gestures in the launcher. So maybe you're having touch responsiveness issues, or maybe swipe gestures from left to right, and they're just not working right. They should have fixed this in this particular update, again, for all supported Pixel devices. And then finally, if you're using a screen protector on a Pixel 4a, they've improved touch sensitivity if you're using that. And so if you were having touch responsiveness issues on your new Pixel 4a, it should fix those issues. So that's it for all of the improvements or features in this particular update. Now, there was a Pixel feature drop a couple weeks ago with the launch of Android 11 that gave augmented reality views in Google Maps and a couple prioritized features such as app suggestions and things like that. Other than that, though, there's not a whole lot in this particular update. However, with the launch of the Pixel 5, Google announced that there's new features coming to these devices as well. So to older devices, such as if you didn't see it when you're making a phone call, maybe someone puts you on hold, your phone can take over the hold. So you don't have to wait there listening to it and then let you know when someone is off of hold or they've taken you off of hold so that you can pick up your phone and continue your conversation. And so those sorts of features are coming soon. Of course, once that's in an update, I'll be sure to keep you posted about that. Now, as far as security updates, well, there's quite a few in this one, and it covers all devices, not just Pixel devices. And the first one is there's one Android runtime update. There's five framework updates, 4 media framework updates, 10 system updates, 2 Google Play system updates, 1 kernel update. There's 5 media component fixes, 4 Qualcomm component fixes, as well as 18 Qualcomm closed source component fixes. And all of those things have been repaired with this particular update and should leave your device much more secure, even though it wasn't that insecure before. So it should be a nice little update. It's a very small update installed nice and quickly. And so far things are nice and fast. Of course, it's going to take a few days to know for sure how it's going to respond. Everything in general seems to be working great though. And this is my secondary phone, so I carry this with me everywhere and use it regularly. So it should be nice and fast, no issues. I really didn't have any issues on the previous September update or Android 11, but this should improve anything you were having issues with, especially that touch responsiveness with the Pixel 4a or some devices with swipe gestures and things like that. Now, if you've found anything specific that I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below and help us figure out what's new in this if they didn't tell us about it. And then also, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.